Hi all, welcome to Dev to Prod Coding. This is Mohit, and in today's video we are going to see about Spring Data JPA with Spring Boot. So when we implement any new application, as a developer we should focus on a business logic instead of technical complexities and some boilerplate code, isn't it? So that is why the Java Persistent API and the Spring Data JPA are extremely popular for. So considering that, in this video we are going to develop a Spring Boot project. In that Spring Boot project we are going to use Spring Data JPA. So we are going to see some basic operations like create, read, delete, update, and some advanced features of Spring Data JPA. Boot application, we can use Spring Initializer or we can use IDE like IntelliJ or STS. So on my screen you can see this is Spring Initializer. So we have to provide some couple of details to Spring Boot project, like Maven project, the language. So for this course we will be using Java, the Spring Boot version which we are going to use, and then the group ID, artifact ID, package name, the packaging, whether it, so when we package our Spring Boot application, is it going to be a jar file or a var file, and which version of Java which we are going to use. So for now I will be using Java 8. So in this right hand side of the section you have add dependencies option. So for example, if I search web, here you can see we can add Spring web dependencies. So for this course I will be using my IDE to create the project. So let's begin with that. So I have selected Spring Initializer and then the version of my JDK. Next. Okay, so for group ID let's call it dev2prod. So I will call it Spring Data JPA. So type is Maven project, Java version I'm going to use 8, name, package. Okay, so let's click on next. Here we have to select the dependencies. So we will be creating API. So for that we need Spring Web. Next is, so we will be using a database. So for that I will be using MySQL. So MySQL driver I need. So we will be using Lombek to generate data, getter, setters, data JPA. So these are the four dependencies that I want in my Spring Boot project. So let's click on the next. Finish. So all the import is done. So now you can see the our basic Spring Boot project is ready. So we have this pom.xml. So let's see what we have. So we have Spring Boot startup parent. So for that we have selected 2.52 version. So we will be using this one. So and the dependencies, so like JPA dependency that we have it, and the starter web dependency that we added, MySQL connector and Lombok. We go to source and we go to this Java. So here you can see we have our Spring Boot starter file. So this contains a method called main. Inside it calls to run. So from here our application, Spring Boot application, will start. Okay, so now it's ready. So let's begin with our actual JPA implementation. So for this what I will be creating, I will be creating a class called employee, and that employee class can have multiple properties. For example, an employee can have employee ID, name, age, phone number, so designation was salary. So to create a entity, so when we say entity, that means we are mapping our database table to that Java class basically. So let's create that. So first of all I will be creating a package called entity. Inside entity I will create a class called employee. So here you can see, so the very first thing is we can use annotation called entity. So by defining this entity, we inform Spring Boot that this class is my entity class. Now let me add some properties to it. So for example, an employee can have employee ID, right? A name, age, then we have phone number, then we have designation, and last but not the least, we have say salary double salary. Okay, now like I said, we have to map this into DB, right? So the very first thing is we have to define a primary key, right? So for that we have an annotation called ID. So when I say employee ID is my ID, that means employee ID will be my primary key. And also, whenever I want to insert employee data, I don't want to insert this employee ID manually. I want it to be automatically generated. So for that, I can use generated value annotation. Inside it, we can define the strategy. So auto generation type auto. So automatically it will increment and it will generate this employee ID for us. So in the same way, we can do for others. So some specific name of your column, so you can have that by using a notation called column, and inside column you can define say phone number. Yes, also by default the table name will be created based on the class name. So if you want to have some custom name, so you can use this table annotation, and this table you can define whatever name you want. For example, if you want t underscore employee, so the table will be created by the name t underscore employee. So for this tutorial, let's now keep it simple and let have it only employee. Next step is to create a repository. So basically when I say repository, so the Spring Data JPA gives us methods to perform read write and all those operations. So let's create a package repository. Inside this package I will be creating an interface, so I'm calling it employee repository. And I will extend it from JPA repository. So in this JPA repository, we have to pass the entity name to which this repository is associated. So for us, it is employee, and the type of my primary key. So the primary key here is employee ID, and the type is long. So long. Let me just import the class. So that's it. Now this repository is also ready. Let's go to my application properties. So we will be saving all the employee related data into our DB. So for that, let's connect to SQL database. So for that we need couple of properties. Let me just add them here. Okay, so here you can see we have these properties. So for now let's leave this. So we have a database URL, username, password, driver class. So here we will be using MySQL. So for that the driver class is this. Let's try it. So before that, so this is my MySQL workbench. So first thing is let's create a schema. So let me name it to Spring Data JPA DB. Let me apply, finish, done. So now here you can see I have this schema. So for now I will set it to default schema. So here you can see we don't have any tables created. So let's do one thing. So with the entity and repository, let's try to boot our application. So let's run this application and see. So now you can see My Spring Boot project is getting a start. Okay, so I got error because I have created the schema name Spring Data JPA DB. I have to pass it here. So Spring Data JPA DB, save it. Okay, so now here you can see create table employee. So we have created only employee class, right? So that is nothing but entity. So based on that @ entity and that associated repository, Spring is able to identify and able to create this employee object in our DB. So let's cross check. Let's refresh. If I go to table, now here you can see, right? So let me, so here you can see there is no data available as of now. So our table is, employee table is now created. Okay, so next thing, let's create a let's create some endpoints to have some basic operations. So let me create a package controller. Inside controller, let me create a class called employee controller. I will annotate this with REST controller because we are going to create endpoints. So the very first endpoint I will be creating is, say, post mapping, and I will say save employee. Okay, public. So I just want to, so whatever I save, I just want to return a list of all the employees which got saved. So it will return list of employee. Let me import list. Okay, so here in the request body, I will have a list of employee. So I'm calling it employee list. Okay, so now next step is, let's create a service class. So we will have this service layer. So for that, let's create a package called service. Inside service, let's create a class called service employee service. Okay, so let me annotate it with service because this is my service class. And let's auto-wire that service class here, employee service. So basically, this method will return me a list of employees, and it will return it from my repository. So in order to use that repository, that is employee repository, we have to auto wire that. Employee repository. So let's name it employee repository, and so let's return employee repository dot. So now here you can see we have a bunch of methods available which we can use. So for now, let's use save all, and in the save all I will be passing the list of employees. Okay, so let me show you one thing. So now we are here in our employee repository. So we have JP repository. If you go to this JP repository, It extends this paging and sorting repository, and inside this paging and sorting repository it extends crude repositories. So this crude repositories, if I show you the type of methods, so here you can see we have readily available methods like count, delete, delete, delete by, find all, save, save all. So these are some of the methods that are readily available. So we are using this only into our service class. So let's go back to our service class, try to boot our application and access it. But to use that endpoint, I will be using Postman. So in the controller we have a method called save employee. But before that, let me do one thing. Every time I don't want to insert this phone number, right, 10 digit for every object. So let's auto generate this phone number. So for that, what we can have is method random dot power 10 is to 10, 10 comma 10. So that means it will give me a number of 10 digit. So okay, same is the case for salary. So let's generate it random and that's it. So in this case I don't have to pass this phone number and salary, and automatically I will be it will be automatically generated. So with that, let's run our application. So my application is started. Let's go to the Postman body. Now here you can see I have already created some object for my employee. So the first one is John. So I'm passing name, age and designation. So here you can see in my employee class I'm just passing a name, age and designation. So employee ID will be taken care by my JPA. The phone number, so we are generating a random phone number from here, and same for the salary. So like this I have created around four to five records. So we have John, Robert, Smith, Bob and Adam. So let's try to see null objects, right? So reason for this is, if we go back to our entity class, so we have declared all the properties and we have used on all the annotations, but we have not created getter, setter and constructor for this, right? So for that we will be using block. So for that we have annotation called data. Yeah, so this data will auto generate all my getter, setter, to string, equal and all those methods. And to have no arc constructor, we have no arc constructor annotation. So that's it. So let's rerun our application and see if it works. So my Spring application is up now. So let's go to my Postman and I'll try to again hit my API. Now this time you can see I got the response 200. Okay, so here you can see we have passed name, age and designation, but in return we have employee ID. So employee ID is set to 1, then the phone number, some 10 digit random phone number and the salary, right? So let's go to our database and here you can see data is got inserted into my employee table. Okay, so this is about creating data. So let's create another endpoint. So it will be a get endpoint and I want to fetch all my list of employees. So let's go to my controller and create a get mapping. So let's say it will return a list of employee employee service dot get employees method. So let's create this method in my employee class, and from here I will return it from my repository. Okay, so this is one thing. Now let's create another point where I want to have only one employee. I want to have an employee based on ID. Get employee by ID, and I will pass the path variable, say employee ID. Let's have a path variable integer employee ID. So get employee by ID, pass employee ID, and let's create this method in my service class. So here let's return, and instead of using already defined methods to fetch this employee, I want to fetch an employee basis on this employee ID. So basically I want to have my custom method. So for that we'll return employee, say find by employee ID, and long ID. Okay, so let's use this method here. So instead of integer, let's make it long employee repository dot find by employee ID. See, so the method that we have created in repository, this is find by employee ID, and I will pass this employee ID. Okay, so let's go to our controller. So instead of integer, let's change it to long, and that's it. Now let's test this get employee and get employee by ID. So let's rerun our application. Okay, so my application is started now. So let's go to the postman. Now here you can see we have get employees, right? So we have get employee. So let's try to fetch. Okay, so now here you can see in the response we have all the employee detail that is available in our database. So I want to fetch only the record which is related to this employee ID too. So for that, let's try that. So for that, we have get employee by ID endpoint, and I can pass ID as 2. So let's see. Now I got the data for Robert, single employee. I'll try to delete some record. So I want to delete a record, say delete by employee ID. So we can use the same thing. We can create our own method here, so it will return the employee that we have deleted. So we have delete by employee ID long ID. Okay, so instead of doing it with the employee ID, let's do it by delete by designation this time, and designation. So based on the designation, we will be deleting our record. Delete mapping. So I want to delete the record based on the designation, and I want to receive designation as a path variable. So let's create a method for the same. Path variable string and designation. So let's create a method in our service class. So return employee service dot say delete employee by designation, pass the designation. And let's create this method. Okay, so here, so this designation, so let me rename it to designation. Now since this designation is a property of our employee class, so let's go to repository and create a custom method which will return a list of employee. And I want to delete by designation, and we'll pass the designation. Okay, so let's use this method in our service class. Return employee repository dot delete by designation, and just pass this designation. So this is done. So let's go to this employee class. So before run this delete endpoint, let's create one more endpoint. So suppose there is a requirement where you want to fetch the employee by name with highest salary. So for example, I'm employee, so I want to short all the employees basis on the name, and out of which I want to find the employee with the highest salary. So how that can be done? Let's do this. So for that, let's create one more endpoint. So let me just copy paste this. Get employee by name. I will pass the name. Or let's do one thing. Instead of name, let's do it get employee by designation, okay. So I will find for all the developers, I just want to find the employee with the highest salary within developers. So yes, that can be done. Let's see. So get employees by designation, get employee by designation, and we'll pass on designation here. Okay, so let's create this method in our service class. Okay, so before creating before using in service class, let's go to our repository and create that method. So basically it will return me a single employee. So I want to find top, so I just want only one record, the top one, by name, and I want to order by that record basis on the salary in descending order. I will pass, so it's not name, it's designation. That's it. So find top basis on designation and reorder by that record by salary in descending order. So basically it will give me the employee with the highest salary for that particular designation. So let's use this in our service class. return employee repository dot find top by designation order by salary description, just pass on this designation. That's it. Okay, so now both the endpoints are ready. So let's run our application and check via Postman. Okay, so my application is up and running. So first we will try this get employees by designation. So before that, let's go to our DB, refresh it. So here you can see we have total three developers, John, Bob and Adam, and the highest salary is, so the highest salary is for Bob. Okay, so I am expecting a Bob object for this endpoint. So let's try to run this. Okay, by designation, and I want to pass developer. First, so I'm expecting the one with the highest salary, and here you can see it's the Bob. So Bob got the highest salary, so that is the reason we have this Bob object. So let's move to the second endpoint. So okay, so I want to delete all the records. So I want to delete all the records. Let's change it to delete by developer. So total we have total three developers. I want to delete those three developers. So let's see. Okay, it returned 200. Okay, let's go to my database, refresh, and here you can see we are left with only two data, that is Robert and Smith, lead and manager. So all the developers are deleted from DB now. So before closing this video, so suppose instead of only one record, if you want to see top two employees with the highest salary for that particular designation, so what you can do, you can use change it to find top two by designation. If you want to see three, if you want to see 10, just add that number and you would be able to get that data accordingly. So that's it for this video. I'll see you in next video. Thanks.